The Mekong Delta is one of the largest deltas in the world, and it's 1.5 times the Netherlands.
And like most other deltas, it has a lack of elevation. It's very much low-lying, so you can imagine that any further land subsidence will increase flood risk in that area.
We have around 22 million people living in the Vietnamese Mekong Delta.
And they produce food for 200 million people. So the region is very important for the food security in Southeast Asia.
We have a good cooperation with the Deltares and Utrecht University with the Vietnamese partner via the rice and phone process.
It is one of the largest deltas that we have on the planet. And this is the first time that we actually modeled the entire delta in terms of groundwater and land subsidence.
And we do it together with our Vietnamese partners so that we ensure that the knowledge that we built is also used in making their policy.
We can use this research to first of all quantify what happened in the past and what's happening right now. And that we want to use in order to also make predictions of the future.
If we understand the behaviors of the subsidence, the local people can have a scenario to prepare to deal with these issues.
So that you can steer policy a bit in the direction that you have in the future also a safe and prosperous Vietnamese Mekong Delta.
I think we have a unique opportunity because it's only quite recently that this delta became in a state that it is at present.
And that's because they started to pump for groundwater since then. And that doesn't mean that all land subsidence now is related to groundwater extraction, but a large part is. And that's actually good news because you can regulate groundwater extraction to a certain extent, and that's much more easy to do than, for instance, natural background subsidence, which is more difficult to handle.
So we can learn from other deltas in the world, and through implementing that knowledge, we can see and try to make sure that land subsidence will not drown the Mekong Delta.